Hi, I'm Will White, Solar Application Specialist at Fluke, and in this DER Tech Talk video, I'm going to discuss earth-ground bonding and why it's important in solar installations. First, it's important to know some definitions. The National Electrical Code Article 250 requires that non-current carrying metal parts all be bonded together and then grounded. Bonded means that the metal parts are electrically connected together, and then grounded means those parts are connected to the earth. So it's important to know the technical difference between bonding and grounding. NFPA 70B, which is the standard for electrical equipment maintenance, table 20.3.5, requires a point-to-point test to verify that our metal parts are actually bonded together. IEC 61557-4 requires that when we're doing this test, we use a tool with a minimum of a 200 milliamp current. Now that's greater than what a standard multimeter uses when doing this continuity type of testing. Most multimeters use a 50 milliamp signal. The ANSI NETA maintenance testing specifications 7.13.D3 requires that when we do this test, the result is lower than half an ohm of resistance. So we want a really low resistance between our non-current carrying metal parts. Now, why is this important? It's really a safety measure. If our metal parts are not bonded together and then grounded, if there should be a ground fault, there's not an easy path for that current to go to ground. This means that if a technician should touch these metal parts that are energized, they may become the easiest path to ground, and that's where shocks and electrocution happens. Also, many overcurrent protection devices like circuit breakers require this path to ground in order to operate properly. So what are we going to measure when we're doing this bonding measurement? Really, we can measure between any two metal parts. In a solar array, it's very common to measure between the module frame, if we have an aluminum frame, and the racking, or the module frame and a ground rod. We can measure between different sections of racking or tables in a solar array. Really, between any two metal parts in the system, they should all be electrically connected together. We're doing this measurement in ohms. In this case, low resistance is good and high resistance is bad. So if we have a low ohm reading, that's a good measurement. Again, less than about half an ohm is what we're looking for according to the ANSI NETA maintenance testing specifications. This is kind of the opposite of an insulation resistance test where we really want high resistance between our current carrying conductor and any grounded metal parts. When doing this type of test, there can be some issues in doing the test itself. A common issue is that a regular standard multimeter doesn't have the current level in order to meet the standards required to do this type of bonding test. One problem that's very common in the solar industry is not making good connections with our test probes. Most of our metal parts in solar are either anodized or they're galvanized, so we have to break through that coating in order to make a good connection with the metal part in order to do the test. So if you're getting a high resistance connection, check your test leads and make sure that they're making a good connection to your metal parts. Sometimes when we have a spool of wire or a spool of test leads like we see in this picture here. This is the 30 meter test lead that comes with the SMFT1000. If that spool is spooled up and the test is being conducted, sometimes we can get high resistance there. So spool the test lead out so that it's not in close contact with itself, and that will often lower the resistance reading from this type of test. If your test is failing, make sure that the test equipment is installed properly before you assume that you have a bad bonding connection. When we're doing this type of test, it's important to know what our objective is. What are the two points we're measuring between? Are we going from the module frame to a ground rod, between different sections of racking? It's good to compare things that are similar so we can see how the results are different if they are. We also need to make sure that we're zeroing out our test leads before we conduct the test. We don't want to include the resistance of the test lead in the measurement because we'll get a bad measurement. Once we've zeroed the leads out, we're going to connect the leads to the points that we're going to measure between. We're going to run the test. Then we're going to record the results and identify any outliers that might need further troubleshooting. And it may be that we need to redo the test, maybe we get bad contact with the test leads, or maybe we just have a bad bond somewhere in that circuit that needs to be repaired. We have several tools that can do this type of test at Fluke. The 1507 insulation resistance tester can do bonding testing at the 200 milliamp level, and so can the SMFT1000. That's our solar multifunction tool. It also includes bonding testing. Thanks for joining me. And for more information on this type of tests and the tools that you can use to do it, check out fluke.com. Thanks.